A spectacular chunk of ice has broken off the Tasman Glacier in the Aoraki Mount Cook National Park. The pale blue waffle-like berg is technically called a calving and tends to happen every few years. Guide Charlie Hobbs said they were expecting it any day, but the result, well, he ranks it in his top five icebergs.
And it looks unbelievable. I mean, we've got some massive icebergs out there that they're going to set us up for the rest of the season, probably next season as well. So we're all really excited about it. And there's some pretty big chunks of ice. I mean, hundreds of millions of tons of ice sitting in the Tasman Glacier Lake. It's just fantastic.
So colour-wise, what does it look like? And just give us a bit of perspective. If you kind of row up there and or paddle up there in a kayak, how high up are you looking at this thing?
Well, obviously, we don't go too close to the big ones in a kayak. Well, you don't need to because they're pretty big and you can see them from a short distance. But, you know, they're pretty big. Remember, you can only see 10% of an iceberg when you're on top of the water. 90% is sitting below. I'm sure you've all seen the movie The Titanic. These bergs are mostly submerged, and when they roll over, well, it's better than whale watching, that's for sure. I mean, it's pretty spectacular.
Charlie, would you say it's beautiful, or how would you describe it?
Oh, stunningly beautiful. It's not something that people get to see every day because, you know, normally you would have to go to the Antarctic or the Arctic or something to see this. But, you know, here we are in a lake in New Zealand where people can just see this incredible thing of nature happening right in front of them in a maritime climate where, like today, for example, it's almost 20 degrees. And,
that must feel bizarre. Yeah, it must feel bizarre, 20 degrees, and you're looking at this thing.
Yeah, it is. That's the unique thing about it, I think, that people can be in a warm environment and see icebergs floating in the water. Pretty spectacular.
Charlie, was there any warning that this was going to happen?
We've been monitoring it for a long time because we fly over with our heli hikes every day. We're out there in the kayaks watching the glacier. And, you know, we actually put bets on with what's happening, and we all kind of figured it would calve about, you know, early February. So we were expecting something to happen, and, obviously getting the correct date is always a tough one, but we knew something was going to happen because we can see the cracks behind the glacier, and so we're all ready for it, but it happened at night while everyone was sleeping, and, and we weren't expecting something that big, but it was pretty good.
I imagine that's quite good that it happened at night, so you didn't have anyone up there too close. Because what are the flow-on effects when it breaks away in such a huge chunk?
Well, the flow-on effects are great for tourism because we get a lot of icebergs floating around for a long time. So, you know, the general public get to come on trips and just experience this phenomena for a long time. And from an educational point of view, you know, most people just don't get to see icebergs. They only read about them in books and magazines and whatever.
If you had to describe this to someone who has no concept of it, can't see it, talk me through it. What does it look like?
Well, if you can imagine several big skyscraper buildings lying on their side in the water, like in Wellington, can you imagine those really, really big buildings? Well, there's quite a few of those lying on the lake at the moment. And all those little small buildings around them, well, they're floating around as well. So we've got skyscraper-size icebergs floating around on the lake.